how long have you been in the industry?
Close to 20 years now.
20 years, okay. How long did it take you to break into the industry? Was it a long process?
About 10 years, yeah.
10 years.
Working in independence and RPGs, like gaming manuals. I did commercial storyboarding, all kinds of whatever work I could find that paid the bills. I was doing graphic work for that, yeah.
Okay, and in the meantime, were you showing your portfolio to different editors, different artists?
Yeah, I was every summer I was going to San Diego, meeting up with editors, showing my portfolio, getting better, and getting critiqued, and then taking those critiques home and working on that over the next few months until the next convention, and submitting working on independent anthologies, all kinds of smaller books. And eventually I met up with Heidi McDonald in the mid-90s, and every year we'd meet up again, and she's like, I got to get you on something. And so for about a couple of years there, I was trying out for several books at Vertigo. It kept hitting a big no from up top, and so it was getting frustrating for a while. And then finally around 2001, got a call from Heidi. It's like, would you like to try out for this book? It's like, I know you're probably sick of us now. And I'm like, well, I'm trying to maybe steer towards more superhero comics, and we'll see what that happens. And it's like, okay, well, try out for this book. I know it's a little weird. I'm going to send you the proposal, see what you think. And are you okay with drawing a book with a huge cast of women? And like, what's this about? And so I read it. I thought it was awesome. I love Brian's take on the story. We tried out. It got greenlit, and that's when Y started.
Great. Okay. Now, let me ask you this. Now, you said it took about 5 years to break into the industry, right?
Yeah.
What do you think was the biggest roadblock for you as far as developing as an artist, that the biggest development you needed to make to get to that professional level?
I think just trying to discern between all the feedback what exactly needed improvement. I think developing that distant eye so you could see where your stuff actually needs improving. I think something that happens with a lot of new artists is they can't see what's wrong with their work. They think that they should be out there with an Eisner Award right away. I did too. And it took a long time to be able to look at my work as like critically and say, oh yes, that's where it needs to be fixed. And that just comes with a lot of practice, a lot of getting to know how the medium works. And right now I do a lot of critiquing of other people's art. I try to help people understand that, because it's a very hard thing to develop. And but once you do, you get better.
Okay, now let me ask you this. You work for DC.
Yes.
Are you excited about the DC reboot?
I'm interested to see what their take on it. I know that there's been a lot of times where I've looked at what DC's done and gone, what are you thinking? I was not a fan of Identity Crisis. I think it just went for too much shock over substance, and it was like waiting to see what was next. And I know there's some really good stuff coming out of DC, but at the same time, there's a lot of stuff that's still falling back on old habits. So if this isn't a way for them to kind of break out of that completely, start fresh, and just go for, go for it as far as telling great stories, fresh stories, abandoning the crap habits, and maybe getting a whole new audience involved, especially digital. I love that idea. I want to see Day and Date. I want to see this succeed so that more people can try it out and get into it. I mean, I love reading manga on the iPad. It works so well, and once the bugs are all sorted, it's a really good experience. And I think it'd be awesome for people who can't get to a comic shop to be able to have access to these stories.